So, have you had any counselling? What support do you
need? No, I'm not ready. My mum has had counselling through South Yorkshire Police. I'm not ready to face it.
Ready, Kerry? Why not? Why do you not think you're ready?
I don't think I'm strong enough to release all that emotion right now. You know, I think I'd rather keep the anger and the fight in me rather than talk about it too much.
Now, they've just announced that more money is going to be allocated to searching for Madeleine McCann.
Yeah.
Obviously, millions of pounds have been spent over the years looking for Madeleine. How does that...
Hurts us, and it hurts me as Ben's mum. You know, we've had... I'm not taking anything away from it at all. You know, she deserves to be found, but so does Ben, you know, and we haven't had a fraction of that help. I've had to fight alone, you know, as a single mum and try to get the help that Ben deserves and that we deserve as a family, but, you know... It did happen in the end, but not to the, you know, not to the magnitude that case has had, which is unfortunately, and it's very, very sad for us. But I'll still keep going. You know, I'll still do the media interviews. Ben's name still needs to be out there while ever he's still missing.
You've been very successful in that regard because Ben is surely, you know, one of the most famous children's names, and you've been so successful with your campaign. But of course, there are people who might say every day in this country children go missing.
Do you know how many go missing, Janet?
No, tell me.
383 children go missing every day in the UK. I mean, a lot of those are, you know, runaways, teenagers,
and
they sometimes come back.
But they still deserve to be found.
That's
how I feel. I don't take anything away from anybody else that has got a loved one that's missing. Mm. You know, unfortunately, Ben never had a say in this. You know, he was only 21 months old. But every person needs to be found. You know, resources must be put into this. And, you know, I find it is unfair. I don't take it, you know, that I'm the only one in the world that feels like this every day, waking up without your child. It's horrendous for every parent. Mm-hmm.
I hope you manage to find a chance to get some counselling for yourself. Because
I will.
I personally feel that it isn't until you can accept something is impossibly
horrible. I don't want to accept that he's gone.
You don't necessarily need to accept that he's gone, but you have to accept that something did happen.
Yeah.
So you can let go enough that you can move on in your life and have a life, and your mum can have a life.
Yeah, I will try.